It's a somber piece. It also is cut with a lot of humor. It has a very hard edge to it. In a way, it's like watching a boxing match. It delivers these blows. But it was an incredibly invigorating experience. It took such a long time to get it made that by the time we were shooting it, I was just so full of excitement and enthusiasm, and I just couldn't believe that it was actually happening.
She was a real champion for me, and that's you don't see that often. And just I never forgot that she was somebody that loved the story so much.
The first time I read the script, and I was hooked from the inside of the front cover page, and then I was flipping the pages and flipping the pages, and it was just so incredible. It was one of the best scripts I've ever had the opportunity to read.
And I feel also that I'm happy that I've pleased the writer. I've pleased Susanna Kaysen. She's happy with the movie, and that is like the greatest feeling ever.
And what's wrong with me? Huh? What the f-
I was in love with the character. I just found her completely, brutally honest without being self-indulgent. Also very funny and intelligent and kind of heartbreakingly human.
What the f*** are you doing? I'm playing the villain, baby. Just like you want.
It's a lot of self-analysis, this film, and so it's hard for me to watch it. She needs to be straight with themselves and not hide who they are. It's not a big deal, and not to be judged or judge people. And I think it's hard that this other person, Susanna, the way she talks about people in that book.
You read how when you were a baby, they strapped you to a board? And how you think Georgina doesn't really want to leave and Polly never will and that I'm criminally insane.
This movie was shot in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania in an actual working mental institution. I felt we were very lucky because it created a really intense environment for us, and it was also a very humbling experience because we were just there making a movie and these people were there living. And you're very grateful to be able to go home when a lot of people weren't able to go home.
It was very intricately detailed in the book how the set decorators and designers and construction worker and Jim had created it. It was created to look exactly how I had envisioned it to look.
That is f***ed up, Daisy. Come on.
It's always great working with incredible actors. To look into honest eyes, it was interesting to learn from them, to see their different processes of how they go about doing what they do.
Angelina is an incredible actress. She's really, really just a raw talent. I mean, her access to her emotions is unbelievable. And as an actor, you know, she gives a lot. She's very generous. It was frightening. It was intimidating. I mean, she would challenge me, and I appreciated that. By surrounding yourself with the best people, you're always better because you come up to the plate more. You know, you want to be as good as them.
Winona just... I had to not actually talk to her too much. If I saw something very human about her, or if I saw, you know, if she would tell me why something hurt her so much, I couldn't be sensitive to her when I saw her. I couldn't think she had a headache in the morning and scream in her face. I couldn't become too close friends with her because I wouldn't have been able to attack her.
Why is all your shit on her bed? Huh? Huh? Why? Why? Where's Jamie?
She's great. I mean, just that she's responsible for kind of getting it to this point.
It was, you know, 6 years of my life, you know, trying to get this movie made. I turned down a lot of work in the process and took a kind of a big gamble. You know, it's not a very commercial premise at all.
It's about the human psyche. I mean, a lot of it, and that's a subject that I think every human being can relate to. You know, I think it's a human movie.
I really wanted to offer girls a character who is someone they could relate to, because I think young women out there are intelligent and are funny and want to see, you know, intelligent, funny, edgy characters who are complicated and human and flawed and great and awful and, you know, have everything going on and are just trying to get through life. You know, boys get a lot of great movies. It's an insult to young audiences and to young women to assume that all they want is, you know, popcorn romantic comedies. I think they really want to be challenged. They want intelligent movies. And so hopefully this will offer them something, even if it just reaches a few people, you know, that'll make me happy.